Mini Chapter 5, Ain't They Freaky by Bang Dead Games. Staring through the window across his study terrace, Jamie thinks back to what he knew about Bang Dead's upcoming new flagship title, Ain't They Freaky. Dud was hired as a senior manager with a specific brief to develop this project, because his previous job had been managing not a games company, but a news conglomerate, precisely the expertise that was needed for this particular game. There were rumours that its hush-hush development phase alone was going to occupy Dud and his team for many months, maybe even a year. Such was its potential value that its details were meant to be confined to those who needed to know, but Jamie managed to find out the basics. If he looks in his email, he may still be able to find something about it. He darts to his computer and taps in a search term or two. Yes, there's a PDF about it, a couple of sides of text written by Dud himself. Jamie sits and reads it at high speed. Oh yes, now it comes back to him. Ain't They Freaky is to be a news-based game, or as this outline puts it, gamified tabloid news. However, its human subject matter won't be restricted to the kinds of people traditionally regarded by popular tabloid outlets as newsworthy fodder through which to sell copies or drive up click-through numbers. This game won't be tied down to using just celebrities or other individuals whose actions or experiences happen to be frameable in such a way as to force them, for a day, into the cartoony mould of some recognised type, such as hero, villain, whore, saint, regular guy, regular gal, winner or loser. No, in this game, any person at all will be fair game for such news treatment, which may be targeted at them by any Ain't They Freaky player at any moment of their lives, for any reason, and irrespective of whether the target is also registered to play the game. The destructive force with which the targeter may hit their target in a newsfeed will depend upon the relative sizes of the targeter's normality score and their targets. To the extent that their own score is the higher one, they will hit their target more destructively, thus earning further normality points in the process. The game will calculate any pair of parties' relative scores by means of instant searches of each party's entire online footprint inside and outside Ain't They Freaky, scoring their normality according to a confidential proprietary algorithm that will factor in such odds and ends as the party's contacts, uploads, known ethnicity, evident sexuality, religious affiliations, politicized activities, and who knows what else. Besides earning normality points, a targeter's other incentive will be to earn money from such online attacks in what amounts to a global marketplace of omnidirectional targeting. Ain't They Freaky will be free for the public to play, but supported by an ecosystem of in-game ads, product placements, and various other kinds of sponsorship and branding, whose display will be triggered by keywords. Falling into the sandbox category of games, it won't have official winners and losers as such, but will rather feel like an environment in which to frolic. Maybe not quite a game at all, in fact, but just a platform. Just a digital platform. Or, in other words, just one of the most powerful things in the world, if Dud and Ashley and the rest of them can design and launch it right. The public's engagement with all this will be powered by good old-fashioned human competitiveness. Players will be encouraged to spend rich years keeping up with the Joneses in many exciting ways, enticed and tallied by the bling of rewards such as freak kill points, super freak kill points, grins, sniggers, glassy eyes, and several more besides, plus a whole bouncing flea circus of adorable emoji and emoticons for easy representation of all permissible online emotions. Central to the overall ethos of Ain't They Freaky will be the principle of championing the most championed. This sacrosanct preferment will be its prevailing blood type, pervading the algorithms by which it will confer its every social reward and its every social censure. For the principle of championing the most championed will derive much of its power from the converse principle, the shaming of the most shamed. In short, Ain't They Freaky will aspire to empower everyone as a tabloid-style news reporter about everyone else. Journalism will become more fun than ever, with the opportunity for a player to earn commissions of real-world money as a gossip columnist or talk show host, through posting sharp judgments about the wacky antics or non-antics of anyone else online. The most celebrated columnists and hosts will earn the social clout that comes with having a personal platform where their uttering a single comment can make or break somebody else's fortunes. If they are truly diligent in championing the most championed and shaming the most shamed, then they may attain the enviable status of official spokesgossip for the game, and some may even be offered share options in it, which will, of course, be a license to print money. The greatest payments will accrue to those judgments that make the greatest social waves. Positive judgments, conceivably, but more likely negative ones. These avenues of championing and shaming will foster a gladiatorial approach to squashing undesirable traits out of social standing, while healthy traits are instilled instead. It's a level playing field for all players. Something like a nature show, in fact. A salute to nature, read in tooth and claw, as Dud's PDF enthuses. Ain't They Freaky will be honoured, in fact, to be one humble part of the grand procession of natural selection, no less, but bracingly accelerated for the digital age. Thus will it facilitate the evolution of our species, by hosting this evolution worldwide within the four corners of the game. It can be a cleansing force in society, so bring on all contenders. Though social in its substance, and although a sandbox, it will borrow much from first-person shooters, as Dud is happy to admit. And for Bangdead, it will have the potential to make a killing through being a killing field. A global platform on which to shore up one's majority credentials, to lever oneself ever higher, up through the bulge of the bell curve, fat above the hub of the spinning world, while snipping off the freaks at the rim to send them away in shame into the void, licking their wounds. Yes, Jamie remembers all this now. It was central to his wanting to leave Bangdead. But having been among the elite within the company's hallowed walls, and being familiar with how the industry goes, he knows that for all the exhausting fun with which Ain't They Freaky is sure to be presented, the dreary ones will assemble this cruel and tacky game with the grimmest humorlessness, the most leadenly pedestrian literal-mindedness, and the glassiest-eyed lack of compassion imaginable, such as to defeat any playful, layered, or humane response one might meet it with, and that Dud's team will have at their disposal so powerful a corporate machine, it is almost certain, alas, that this monstrosity will sweep the world.